Channel Update Mondays.
Hello everybody, my name is The Black Jim and welcome to Channel Update Mondays. I haven't done one of these in a while, and I have no excuse. I'm just lazy. That's my excuse. That's my amazing excuse. I'm lazy. As you can see, I finally got my pop filter to work. A lot of you guys know, well, a few of you guys at least, noticed that the last episode that I did, I was about to say a week ago, but no, because I haven't done an episode for 2 weeks, that the pop filter, which is right here, you saw on the table, and you're like, Jim, you should use it. And I should have used it. I just couldn't find a spot on the desk for me to, like, to clamp the little clampy thing onto, the clampy thing. But yeah, I finally found a good spot, and now I'm using the pop filter, so yeah, so professional. But yeah, this isn't actually my setup when I play games, because obviously the microphone's right in front of the keyboard. I can't actually play when it's right in front of me. I usually have it off to the side. I'm just having it in front of me so you can still, like, see me. Because obviously I'm not playing anything. It's not a big deal. I don't know if that makes any sense. But yeah, Blue Yeti, awesome. I know I've had it for a few weeks, but I'm so enjoying the quality. Let me just listen to it. Listen to this. It's so awesome. But yeah, so I've been meaning to talk about E3 for a while in my videos, but I never actually talked about it in any of my videos. So I'm going to quickly go over what I liked and didn't like about E3. And I know this is really late, but it's really late, but I'll do it anyways. So basically, Microsoft conference, they did live up to the promise. They showed off a ton of games, but none of them really interested me. I can see why some of them would interest people, but still nothing that would make me want to get an Xbox One. It's also $100 more than the PS4. It's going to be $500. I believe the PS4 is going to be $400. So, I mean, even though Microsoft removed all their DRM and used games policies and always online internet connection and stuff, I would still not get one. I don't even know why I even talk about this, because I have no plans of getting a next-gen console. It's just that if I was going to get one, it would be a PS4, if that makes sense. I mean, I'm probably not going to get one, but if I had to get one, it would be a PS4. So, yeah, Microsoft, I can see why some people would like the games, but none of them really interested me. Like, for example, that Roman War game that looked so awesome, it was Rise. At least it looked awesome at the start, but then the game just turned into a bunch of QuickTime events, so, eh, I don't know, it was okay. They did redeem themselves. They showed off games. I can't really help but kind of applaud them, especially after they removed all their DRM and used games and internet connection. Still, I would still rather get a PS4, but nice job, Microsoft. You're slowly fixing the Xbox One. Then they're up next after in the conferences, I believe, was EA. Oh my gosh, they had, like, an amazing conference. Like, Battlefront 3, Mirror's Edge 2, Need for Speed. I believe they had this Dragon Age game. I'm not into RPGs, so I don't really know what it is. I know it's a popular series. I don't play it, though. I don't really know what it's about. But, yeah, it's pretty big, so I assume that RPG fans like it. So, Need for Speed looks awesome. I'm not into racing games, but I'm probably going to get that because that game looks awesome. The Mirror's Edge 2, I didn't play the first one, but I've seen plenty of videos on it. It's like a parkour game. That looks awesome. Apparently, a lot of people have been looking forward to that. But the two grand pieces of EA's conference was Battlefront 3 and Battlefield 4. Okay, those are really similar names, so I keep getting them mixed up. Like, sometimes I say Battlefront 4 and Battlefield 3. Battlefront 3, because that's a game that's already out. What the heck am I talking about? So, yeah, Battlefront 3. I used to play the second Battlefront a lot. It's basically a Star Wars multiplayer shooter. But unfortunately, the studio that made those games closed. But recently, they handed over the rights to EA. And then the EA, like, told DICE, which are the creators of Battlefield, to go make Star Wars Battlefront 3. So I am super excited for that. Like, any game that's made by the same people that made Battlefield is going to be awesome. So Battlefront 3 is going to be amazing. I'm definitely going to get that, as well as Battlefield 4. Battlefield 4 multiplayer looks amazing. I pre-ordered that game, like, 2 days after they finished E3, because after seeing all of the multiplayer footage, I'm just like, I know I haven't played it yet, but I'm going to get it. I don't pre-order many games either, but I'm sure Battlefield 4 will be amazing. I haven't pre-ordered Battlefield 3 yet. I'm not even sure if you can, but, yeah, cool. Then was Ubisoft. They had, Ubisoft, Assassin's Creed. They had this cool racing game called The Crew, Watch Dogs, and a couple of other games. Those all look like awesome games, so Ubisoft's cool. Then there was Sony, actually. Yeah, Sony, derp. I didn't actually watch the whole thing. They did show off with the PS4. It looks like it's kind of like a PS2, which isn't a bad thing. It's nice and slim, so better than the Xbox One's design. Then there was Nintendo. I really love Nintendo's conference. As you know, I'm a little bit of a Nintendo fanboy. I have a Wii U. Wii U! But they announced... They announced Super Smash Brothers. Everyone's looking forward to that. The new Mario 3D game, Mario Kart 8, Donkey Kong, and the Wind Waker HD, and a few other games, I think. But yeah, Nintendo's was awesome. So my top three games of E3 would probably be Battlefield 4 at number one, then the new Super Smash Bros., and then Battlefront 3. So yeah, overall, this was a pretty dang awesome E3, and this is a really late video, but you know, I still have no excuse. So yeah, it was an awesome E3, that's all I'm gonna say. And yeah, I think that's it. Pop Filter, E3, and is that it? Yeah, I think it is. Before I go, one final announcement. My brother has recently started doing videos on YouTube. So his channel is Bandit1456. The link will be in the description, and an annotation will be on the screen, so just click anywhere on the screen, and it'll bring you to his channel. He only has two videos so far up, I think. But yeah, go check him out and give him some support. That's it for this episode of Channel Update Mondays. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you later. Oh my gosh, another straight down drop. Well, it's not as big, but still. Yeah. See? Oh my gosh!